Hi everyone, this is Dan O'Neill, the director of the Ethan Allen Homestead Museum, and I'm really excited to announce our weekly video newsletter. Our touring season ends this Saturday, but every week we're going to bring you a video newsletter that will share certain interesting things that are happening, will happen, or that we have around here at the Homestead, so you can keep active on what's going on and some of the research we've been doing on the objects and the people that lived here over the years. If you have suggestions or any kind of thoughts as to what we should show, please do not hesitate to leave a comment or send us an email with a suggestion of something you'd like to learn about the Homestead and some of the things that are here.
I want to begin by explaining how we arrived at the inventory of the Allen House. It's important to note that there are very few objects that can accurately be documented as having been owned by Ethan Allen. There are lots of documents about him that can be pieced together, but as far as objects that can be labeled as definitively being Ethan Allen's, there are very few out there. Here's what we do know. We do know that 7 months after Ethan's death, Ira Allen performed an inventory of the contents of the home. Present at that inventory was Mrs. Allen, his second wife, and Lucy Caroline Allen Hitchcock, who was Ethan's daughter from his first marriage. There was a great deal of concern at that inventory that objects that belong to Ethan's first wife, Mary, go to her children, and likewise for Fanny and her children. And there was also a lot of disagreement about it. The records indicate that Fanny complained that Lucy took a larger share of the items. Our source for this is the Udney Hay papers kept by the Vermont Historical Society. Udney Hay was Fanny and her subsequent husband, Jabez Pennyman's attorney, and he represented them in a lawsuit against Ira Allen to secure her inheritance, which Ira tried to block her from. Sadly, that inventory has not been found. And the founders of the museum looked a lot at probate records for families in the area of a similar socioeconomic status to try to reconstruct the inventory of homes like the Allens during this time period. In recent years, we are looking at family correspondence and specifically looking at objects that are noted as having been in the house to develop an inventory that would match what was found in the region. A lot of the letters indicate that the Allens were not wealthy at all. In fact, they were quite poor. Hay's record says that Ethan sold many items for cash to support the family, and the correspondence really tells of a lot of anxiety about money. So many of the objects we'll share with you are mentioned in the documents or uncovered by archaeologists. Now, just as a teaser for this week, I'm sharing a page from The Gentleman's Magazine from February 1778. We have an original print of this on display in the museum. It reports on news from the Revolution. Now, this piece that you're looking at, keep in mind this is only about 4 months after Burgoyne's surrender in October 1777. And you can read this section, which described efforts to exchange Ethan Allen, who was a prisoner of war at the time. Now, the magazine that it's published in was published in London from 1731 to 1907. And in this issue, they were reporting on what was going on with the American Revolution. And the documents that they are publishing are extracts from official documents published by the Continental Congress. And it shows that American forces were very concerned with ensuring that officers were exchanged for those of equal rank, and that captured American soldiers be treated as prisoners of war and not criminals. That was a very key concern, and that policy of treating rebel officers as POWs and not as criminals would actually remain part of US POW doctrine right up through the Civil War. If you're interested more about Ethan Allen's time as a prisoner of war, I'm including a link to a lecture about the exchange process in the description. And we're going to see you next week with another video newsletter. If you have any suggestions or any curiosities, please let us know. We really will do our best to include certain topics for you. Also, please remember that we rely on the support of people like you to fund our operations. So please donate securely online at www.ethanallenhomestead.org. Thanks, and we'll see you next week.